Hey everyone, this is Jason, and today's vlog is going to be something of a simple public service announcement about our Open Accelerate methodology. Those of you familiar with Accelerate know that our Open Accelerate methodology is the process that we put in place to allow our users, to allow our customers to create their own custom logic blocks or custom accelerator blocks for the Accelerate board and to be able to upload that to the FPGA. The cool thing about it is it doesn't require you to purchase any special hardware or purchase any special FPGA design tools. You can design for Max 10 as your FPGA target using Intel's Cortus Prime Lite, which is free. And then the methodology that we've created actually allows you to upload your new image to the FPGA through the Arduino IDE, so you don't need any kind of special JTAG hardware or USB blaster or anything like that. So that's Open Accelerate. And we do have an Accelerate webinar on this YouTube channel that you can check out if you want to learn how to do that. We're actually going to be upgrading that because here's the announcement that I need to make. We're currently making changes to Open Accelerate, and the changes we're making are related to making it a little bit easier for you to interact with the code. The things you have to do now to get your accelerator blocks wired in or to get them integrated into the top level for making changes to the FPGA are a little cumbersome and not particularly clean, and we want to fix that for you. And we've actually made those changes and have pushed those out to our GitHub account. So if you go into the Arduino IDE, you'll probably see that a new package is available for you for Open Accelerate. Now, here's the thing. It will work and you can use it, but there currently isn't any documentation on our website for how to use it. And if you follow along in our webinar videos, it's not going to match when you get to the part about changing things at the top level file. However, if you're currently using Open Accelerate, that means that you're likely comfortable making changes to the Verilog at the top level, so you won't have too much trouble figuring out what's changed in the hierarchy of the files. And if you do have questions, feel free to jump over to our forums and just ask some questions or shoot us an email directly. We would be glad to get in touch with you and help you out. We're going to be getting ready to create some new videos soon of how to use the new Open Accelerate flow. The rest of it really has stayed pretty much the same. It's pretty much just the file hierarchies that have changed. And so the way things are grouped and the way things are organized are a little easier to follow and a little easier for you to implement your accelerator blocks. If you want to learn more about our Open Accelerate methodology, head over to alloriumtech.com/openaccelerate. And you'll get a lot more details there. Keep in mind that the information there is relative to the original version of Open Accelerate. So we'll be changing that very soon as we get our training videos up. Thanks for being patient with us. And if you have any questions, reach out and let us know. Thanks for watching. I hope you're having a great week. Join us tomorrow as we continue vlogging every day in August. Take care.